If you're watching this video, I can only assume you're a filmmaker. Did you ever experience this? You come home from a shoot, you feel great, you sit down and plug in your hard drive and watch. You watch what you've done and you think to yourself, that looks pretty damn good. This is gonna be awesome. Only thing left is to listen that it sounds all right to. And fuck. I messed up the sound. The video looks fantastic, but it sounds horrible. Starts out as anger, slowly turns into sadness, hopelessness, total disparity. How could this happen? I mean, this is what I do. That's the thing I'm supposed to be good at. The job was easy. Record acoustic guitar and vocals. Something I've done 1,000 times before. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. And yet, here I am. I messed it up. Life is now divided into before and after. I will never again be the person I was yesterday. There's a void in my heart that's never gonna be filled. Days will turn into weeks. Weeks will grow into months. Food won't taste the same, and activities I used to love is now merely a way to pass the time. I messed up. Days into weeks. And then, out of nowhere, there it was. The answer to all my prayers. Music Remixer.
Hey guys, just wanted to share a little trick that I found. I'm working on a documentary series right now called It's Only Life, and the first two episodes are already out on this channel, so if you want to check them out, I'll be super happy. In the first episode, I meet Thomas Larsen, which is a friend of mine who lives in Malmö. He's working as a producer, and once the interview was done, we were quite pressed on time because I had to go back to Hamburg and he had to go and pick up his kid, I think. So we had like 2 hours to do the interview and B-roll, which is crazy that we got anything done. But he did a great job answering my questions, so that went pretty quickly. But we had, I would say, 5 minutes before we had to be out of his studio.
First 5 minutes free.
And instead of shooting B-roll, I said, just turn around and pick up your guitar and sing a song. And he did, but I didn't have time to set up the audio. So I just took this very microphone I'm recording on right now, which I used for his interview, and just spun it around and recorded him singing. I wish I would have just put the microphone, you know, in front of him, picking up the guitar and the vocal equally, but we didn't have time. I didn't have time to sound check. I just saw the levels, but the microphone was above him, so naturally it picked up his voice more than the guitar, and I think to me it sounded a little bit off balance. I wanted some more guitar. Anyway, this is how it sounded.
You're toughing your heart, I'm watching the accident. I'm sitting here and I'm jolting on.
So, as you can hear, the guitar is a little bit low in the mix. This is, by the way, totally, I didn't do anything to this audio yet. So what I thought I could do is to use the new Music Remixer they have here in DaVinci. And so I just try that. I'm gonna put on headphones for this. So here's what we have.
You're toughing your heart, I'm watching the accident.
So I'm gonna try to get the guitar up a little bit here.
I'm sitting here and I'm jolting all the words down. Give me a minute before you cry on my shoulder.
somewhere here. This works, definitely got better. But what I wanted to do was to put some reverb or spice up the guitar a little bit, but not necessarily the vocals so much. And how would you do that? Because you only have one mono channel and the guitar and the voice are on it. So this is the one track I have. I just copy that 2 times. And I think you know where I'm going with this. So now I have 2 identical tracks here with guitar and vocals. So I just go on Music Remixer on the first one and I mute the voice. I go Music Remixer on the second one and I mute the guitar. And that sounds something like this. So this is only the guitar. It's a little bit noisy. I know it's this weird frequencies. So what you could do is just take the voice down. Instead of muting it. Yeah, you can hear these weird computer sounds, digital noise artifacts, I don't know.
Those crazy noises are computer signals.
But when the vocal comes on top, it's actually not that bad. It covers it up pretty good. So that's the guitar. What I could do here is also some EQ. Cut a little bit here and bim bim boom. So then we have the vocal, and that should be only vocal on this one.
Watching you sleep, watching as your eyes move.
And together they sound like this.
I'm sitting here with folk.
And now you have complete freedom to do whatever you want with these 2 tracks, which is pretty sick because you couldn't do this almost 6 months ago, at least not in video editing like this.
Before you cry on my shoulder.
So now I can go in here to Fairlight and start mixing the song as if it was 2 microphones. Pretty cool. So I could add here to the guitar, I could add some kind of reverb.
Cry on my shoulder.
I could put a little slap delay on the vocal here.
Sitting here and I'm jolting all the words down. Give me a minute before you cry on my shoulder. Sitting here and I'm jolting all the words down.
Just to make it a little bit bigger than it is, and also to separate it from the guitar a little bit.
Sitting here and I'm jolting all the words down. Give me a minute before you cry on my shoulder.
Of course, in a setting like this, you don't want too many effects going, but it's for illustration purposes. It's all for you.
A minute before you cry on my shoulder. I'm watching you sleep, watching as your eyes move. I'm not thinking right now, I don't have to. I'm sitting here with photos of what to come, babe. Give me a minute before you cry on my shoulder, cry on my shoulder.
So there you have it. That's pretty much the trick. I don't know if I came up with it, but for me, I did. I never seen anyone do it. I'm sure everyone's doing it, but I was happy when I found it. One of those happy accidents, just messing around and then like finding a solution like that. It's that stuff that can make a nerd like me happy anyway. So there it is. I mean, we went from this.
You're the moon, oh, you're growing on a concrete bed.
To this.
You're the moon, oh, you're growing on a concrete bed.
And I can still hear the noise, the little sparkle, digital, annoying thing from the guitar. But confession, I actually didn't mix this in Fairlight. I did it in Logic, so I just exported the files and did it in Logic.
Traitor!
Using this music remixer. And because I had to save some of that sparkle thing, and also I could do everything here in Fairlight. You could mix an album here. It's just that I'm more at home in Logic. It's kind of second nature to do mixing in there, so that's why I did it. But you can absolutely do it everything in DaVinci if you wanted to. So that's the trick. This was the first project I used the music remixer on, and I actually used it twice. At the very end of this episode, he's talking kind of lightly, and it's like a fun ending, I guess. And I wanted it to lead into one of his songs as an outro song. So this is
passenger side.
And I wanted this part of the chorus to be playing under the credits, the end credits.
That's coming down.
Here, this part here.
Somebody better let you go.
So I wanted that to kind of lead in under his talking at the very end. So his talking is like this.
You like cocoa on your pizza?
And that's where I wanted the song, the chorus of the song to start. So I'll put that in place. It's right here. So that's how I want that to go. And I really like the part leading into the chorus, because it's like a down part of the song, but I thought the vocals interfered a bit with his talking. So, I mean, it's even the same voice singing and talking. So I just looped the part that I like.
Passenger.
And that sounds like this.
Passenger side. Passenger.
And I think that works, but I wanted the vocals to go away. Music remixer. So I just put these loops on a separate track, so I could use that track for only the music remixer. So I just simply mute the voice, and that would sound like this. I mean, that's magic. That's For me, this is, I mean, I could ask him for the stems of the song and just take the vocal away. But to be able to do this in 5 seconds is unbelievable to me, and so helpful. And it goes to show what I always say about when people are, you know, scared about AI or whatever. I mean, this is a tool that you can use for a productive end goal. And, you know, for me, the faster I can reach my end goal, the better. And if it's AI, it's just a tool. It's just a tool if you use it like this. So I think that really works. So I have the muted voice channel here, and then I want the vocals to come in to the end. So I just mix these two together on the normal, and it's like a fade coming into the chorus. So the whole thing sounds like this.
Be honest with what you have. You know, okay. Hey, let's go make pizza. You like cocoa on your pizza? Somebody better let you go.
And that's it. Hopefully you'll find it as helpful as I did. I mean, there's a million ways to use this, and you know, go crazy and have fun with it. If you stuck out this long, thank you so much for watching. I'm having so much fun doing this, even though my bitchy resting face is not telling you that story exactly. But please subscribe, like, and be kind to each other, and have a good one.